Hello friends, today we will discuss about the heat radiation. Actually, there are two parts of heat radiation. In first part, we will discuss about heat radiation, that is the process of heat transfer, means conduction, convection, radiation. Especially, we focus on the radiation in this topic. Next, absorption, reflection and transmission of heat. Then we discuss about the coefficient of absorption, coefficient of reflection, coefficient of transmission, and then we discuss about the perfectly black body, emissive power, emissivity and Pivot's theory of heat exchange. And in next part we discuss about the black body radiation spectrum, Stefan's law, Kirchhoff's law, Newton's law of cooling. Okay, then start heat radiation. What is heat radiation, or what is about the heat transfer process? There are three types of heat transfer. First is conduction, second one is convection, and third one is radiation. What is conduction, convection and radiation? सगळ्यात पहिल्यांदा हे लक्षात घ्या की कंडक्शन म्हणजे काय, कन्व्हेक्शन म्हणजे काय आणि रेडिएशन म्हणजे काय, या तिघांनाही समजून घ्या, मग आपण रेडिएशन या टॉपिकवर फोकस करू. रेडिएशन या टॉपिकवर जाऊ. तर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी डिस्कस अबाउट द कंडक्शन. व्हॉट इज कंडक्शन ऑफ हीट? स्पेशली वी डिस्कस अबाउट द हीट ट्रान्सफर. सो वी डिस्कस अबाउट द हीट. सो कंडक्शन ऑफ हीट, नॉट कंडक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, कंडक्शन ऑफ हीट. कंडक्शन मीन्स हीट ट्रान्सफर फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर प्लेस थ्रू द पार्टिकल्स ऑफ द मीडियम. मीन्स सपोज वी टेक द एक्झाम्पल ऑफ स्टील रॉड. स्टील रॉड इज हीटेड फ्रॉम वन साइड and heat is transferred to the other side also. Why? Because electrons or free electrons are responsible for the conduction. These free electrons transfer the energy electron to electron, or we can say it's a particle to particle transfer of heat. That is conduction. In this, particle never carry along with the energy. Energy sobat particle carry honar nahi. फक्त एनर्जी कॅरी होते, एनर्जी ट्रान्सफर होते एका ठिकाणून दुसऱ्या ठिकाणी. दिस प्रोसेस इज कॉल्ड ॲज कंडक्शन. याला कंडक्शन म्हणता येईल. फॉर एक्झाम्पल असं कन्सिडर करा की मी क्लासमधल्या शेवटच्या बेंचवरच्या मुलाला त्याचं नोटबुक मागितलं आणि तो नोटबुक देतो आहे. त्यांनी पुढच्या बेंचवर दिलं, त्यांनी नेक्स्ट याच्यावर दिलं, त्यांनी नेक्स्ट याच्यावर कॅरी करत गेले आणि ते माझ्यापर्यंत आलं. या प्रोसेसमध्ये काय होते, पार्टिकल नेवर कॅरी अलॉंग विथ द एनर्जी ऑर अलॉंग विथ द हीट. In the same way, the particle carry the energy, particle to particle, and that is known as conduction. Example, steel rod is heated on one side, heat is transferred up to the other end. That is conduction. Second one, what is convection? Convection is again the process of heat transfer definitely. Process of heat transfer means heat transfer from one place to another place. But in convection, the particles of the medium carry along with the energy. For example, water heated in a pot. In this process, the heat is transferred from bottom of pot to the top of the water. Means the molecules of the water which is heated, they are moved in upward direction, and heat transfer from bottom to top. म्हणजे लक्षात घ्या की वॉटर हीटेड इन ए पॉटचं एक्झाम्पल जर घेतलं तर पाण्याचा पहिल्यांदा अप्पर सरफेस गरम व्हायला लागतो, बॉटम नाही. सो हीट ट्रान्सफर फ्रॉम बॉटम टू टॉप, पार्टिकल मूव अलॉंग विथ द एनर्जी, मूव अलॉंग विथ द हीट, अँड दॅट इज कन्व्हेक्शन. याला कन्व्हेक्शन म्हणता येईल. वॉटर हीटेड इन ए पॉट हे कन्व्हेक्शनचं बेस्ट एक्झाम्पल समजलं जातं. या केसमध्ये मॉलिक्युल्स ट्रॅव्हल ऑर मॉलिक्युल मूव अलॉंग विथ द एनर्जी, अलॉंग विथ द हीट. याला कन्व्हेक्शन म्हणतो. अँड थर्ड वन, इट्स अ इम्पॉर्टंट पार्ट ऑफ अवर टॉपिक, दॅट इज द रेडिएशन. आपल्या टॉपिकवर आपल्याला हेच फोकस करायचं आहे की रेडिएशन म्हणजे काय. रेडिएशन इज नथिंग बट इट इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ हीट ट्रान्सफर अगेन. बट इन रेडिएशन, हीट ट्रान्सफर फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर प्लेस इन द फॉर्म ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमॅग्नेटिक वेव्स. या ठिकाणी जी एनर्जी ट्रान्सफर होणार आहे ती इलेक्ट्रोमॅग्नेटिक वेव्सच्या फॉर्ममध्ये एनर्जी ट्रान्सफर होणार आहे. तर दॅट इज रेडिएशन. डेफिनेशन जर करायची झाली तर आपण अशी करता येईल का, रेडिएशन इज नथिंग बट इट इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ हीट ट्रान्सफर फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर प्लेस इन द फॉर्म ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमॅग्नेटिक वेव्स इज कॉल्ड ॲज radiation, and this energy transfer is called as radiant energy. For example, जर पाहायचं असेल तर example घेता येईल heat transfer from sun to earth in the form of electromagnetic radiation. सूर्यापासून sunlight ज्याला म्हणतो आपण त्याच्यासोबत heat सुद्धा येते आहे, and this heat is nothing but it is the radiation. So that is radiation. It is a transfer in the form of electromagnetic waves, electromagnetic radiations. So process of heat transfer from one place to another place in the form of electromagnetic waves is called as radiation, and the energy is called as radiant energy. काही properties लक्षात घ्या. There are some properties of the heat radiation. First of all, heat radiation is very rapid process. Conduction, convection पेक्षा heat radiation ही rapid process आहे. Rapid म्हणजे very fast process. Because the speed of heat radiation is equal to speed of light. That is nothing but it is the speed of electromagnetic waves. 3×10⁸ meter per second ज्याला म्हणतो आपण speed of light. तर एवढ्या speedने ती heat transfer होत जाईल from one place to another place. याला म्हटलं जातं heat radiation. Second property लक्षात घ्या, heat radiation are invisible. It's the most important property. Heat radiation ही invisible आहे. Invisible का आहे? Because it is the part of electromagnetic radiation, which is the part of infrared radiations. Infrared radiation च्या range मध्ये तो आहे. That is wavelength range is from 10,000 angstrom to 1 millimeter. Means we can say it's a 10⁻⁶ meter to 10⁻³ meter. Means shortly जर सांगायचं झालं तर 1 micrometer to 1 millimeter. या रेंज मध्ये ते हीट रेडिएशन असतात, आणि हा जो पार्ट आहे हा इन्फ्रारेड रेडिएशनचा पार्ट आहे. इन्फ्रारेड रेडिएशन्स आर इनविजिबल. म्हणून दुसरी प्रॉपर्टी आपण अशी कन्सिडर करू का, इलेक्ट्रोमॅग्नेटिक वेव्स ऑर सॉरी हीट रेडिएशन्स आर इनविजिबल. थर्ड प्रॉपर्टी लक्षात घ्या, इलेक्ट्रोमॅग्नेटिक वेव्स डज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड मीडियम फॉर इट्स प्रोपोगेशन. इट कॅन प्रोपोगेट थ्रू द व्हॅक्युम ऑल्सो. इलेक्ट्रोमॅग्नेटिक वेव्स आहेत, त्याला मीडियमची गरज नाही, व्हॅक्युम मधूनही जातील. सो हीट रेडिएशन कॅन पास थ्रू द व्हॅक्युम ऑल्सो. इट डज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड मीडियम फॉर इट्स प्रोपोगेशन. थर्ड प्रॉपर्टी मध्ये आपल्याला असं सांगता येईल का, हीट रेडिएशन कॅन प्रोपोगेट थ्रू द व्हॅक्युम. इट डज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड मीडियम. ओके, अँड नेक्स्ट प्रॉपर्टी, इलेक्ट्रोमॅग्नेटिक वेव्स आहेत त्यामुळे हीट रेडिएशन ओबेज ऑल द लॉज ऑफ लाईट, सेम ॲज दॅट ऑफ द लॉज ऑफ लाईट. फॉर एक्झाम्पल रिफ्लेक्शन, refraction, it is propagated along the straight line, it is diffracted, it is reflected, all these properties are obeyed by the heat radiations. These are the properties of heat radiations. Okay, now we discuss about the absorption, reflection and transmission of heat by the body. Consider I be the total amount of heat energy incident on the body, IA be the amount of energy absorbed by the body, IR be the amount of energy reflected from the body, and IT be the amount of energy transmitted through the body. So consider I be the total amount of energy incident on this body. Out of this energy I, some part of energy is absorbed by the body, that is IA, some part of energy is reflected from the body, that is IR, and remaining part is transmitted through the body, that is IT. So we can say that is the law of conservation of energy also. I is equals to IA plus IR plus IT. Means amount of energy absorbed plus amount of energy reflected plus amount of energy transmitted is equals to total amount of energy. So I is equals to IA plus IR plus IT. Again, we have to discuss about the coefficient of absorption, coefficient of reflection and coefficient of transmission. We consider I be the amount of energy incident. आपण असं कन्सिडर करतोय की I एवढी एनर्जी त्या बॉडीवरती इन्सिडेंट करतो आहे. या बॉडीमध्ये I एवढ्या एनर्जीचा काही एनर्जी ऍब्सॉर्ब होते आहे, काही रिफ्लेक्ट होते आहे, काही ट्रान्समिट होते आहे. तर कोइफिशियंट ऑफ ऍब्सॉर्प्शन काय असेल? व्हॉट इज कोइफिशियंट ऑफ ऍब्सॉर्प्शन? कोइफिशियंट ऑफ ऍब्सॉर्प्शन मीन्स इट इज द रेशियो ऑफ, इट इज डिनोटेड बाय स्मॉल ए. कोइफिशियंट ऑफ ऍब्सॉर्प्शन इज द रेशियो ऑफ amount of energy absorbed by the body to the total amount of energy incident on it. Means small a is equals to IA by I. That is coefficient of absorption. absorption coefficient असे ही म्हटला जाईल, इट इज डिनोटेड बाय स्मॉल a. नेक्स्ट कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ रिफ्लेक्शन, व्हाट इज कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ रिफ्लेक्शन, कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ रिफ्लेक्शन मींस इट इज द रेशियो, इट इज डिनोटेड बाय स्मॉल r, इट इज द रेशियो ऑफ अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी रिफ्लेक्टेड दैट इज ir टू द टोटल अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी इंसिडेंट ऑन इट, मींस स्मॉल r इज इक्वल्स टू ir बाय r, ir बाय r दैट इज कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ रिफ्लेक्शन, स्मॉल r इज इक्वल्स टू ir बाय r. एंड नेक्स्ट कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन, that is the transmission of heat, coefficient of transmission is denoted by small t and it is the ratio of, it is defined as coefficient of transmission is nothing but it is the ratio of amount of energy transmitted by the body or through the body to the total amount of energy incident on it, means small t, coefficient of transmission is small t is equals to it by r, so amount of energy transmitted divided by total amount of energy, T is equals to IT by R, it is coefficient of transmission. Okay, so coefficient of absorption, coefficient of reflection, coefficient of transmission, it is related by this equation, small a plus small r plus small t is equals to 1, coefficient of absorption plus coefficient of reflection plus coefficient of transmission is equals to 1. Okay, this is relation between absorption coefficient, reflection coefficient and transmission coefficient, that is a plus r plus t is equals to 1. So this is about the amount of energy absorbed, amount of energy reflected and amount of energy transmitted by the body. Again we discuss about the two definitions, simple thing, what is about the diathermous substance and athermous substance, diathermous and athermous. Diathermous means, it is a very simple definition, diathermous means the substances which can the heat radiate, which can pass the heat radiations, or the substances through which the heat radiation can pass is called as diathermous substances. For example, metals, that is copper, steel, iron, through this metal heat radiation can pass, means it is the diathermous substance. Diathermous substance manun manje ja material madun ja substances madun heat radiations pass hota. लाईटच्या बाबतीत जर आपण म्हटलं तर वी कन्सिडर टू टाइप्स ऑफ मटेरियल, दॅट इज ट्रान्सपरंट मटेरियल अँड ऑपॅक मटेरियल. ट्रान्सपरंट म्हणजे ज्याच्यातून लाईट पास होतो, तसंच हीट रेडिएशन ज्याच्यामधून पास होते त्याला आपण म्हणतो डायथर्मोनस सब्स्टन्स. फॉर एक्झाम्पल, थ्रू द मेटल बॉडीज हीट रेडिएशन कॅन पास, सो इट्स अ डायथर्मोनस सब्स्टन्स. अँड सेकंड वन इज अथर्मोनस सब्स्टन्स. अथर्मोनस सब्स्टन्स मीन्स द सब्स्टन्सेस through which the heat radiation cannot pass, means in short we can say it's a bad conductor of heat, simple, it's a bad conductor of heat, means suppose there is a piece of wood through which the heat radiation cannot pass, means it's a athermous substance. Wood or bakelite or some materials which sustain the heat but heat radiations cannot pass is called as diathermous substances. Diathermous substances. Okay, next we have to discuss about the perfectly black body, which is very important and interesting concept of the heat radiation, that is perfectly black body. Perfectly black body means what is perfectly black body? Perfectly black body is nothing but a body which absorbs all the heat radiations incident upon it. Consider I be the amount of energy incident on the body, and suppose it is a perfectly black body, so I be the amount of energy incident and this amount of energy totally 100% absorbed by the perfectly black body, means there is no reflection, there is no transmission, means amount of energy incident I is equals to IA, means IA is equals to I, means perfectly black body is a body which absorb all the heat radiation incident on it. Okay, this is perfectly black body. Now what are the properties of perfectly black body? First, perfectly black body is absorb 100% heat radiation incident on it, so for perfectly black body coefficient of absorption is unity, that is 1, because IA is equals to I, means coefficient of absorption is 1, means amount of energy absorbed is equals to total amount of energy incident. That is, for perfectly black body, Ia is equals to I, and A means coefficient of absorption is 1. Second property, for perfectly black body, coefficient of reflection is 0, coefficient of transmission is 0. Why? Because no energy is reflected and no energy is transmitted by the perfectly black body. So, coefficient of absorption, coefficient of reflection and coefficient of transmission is equals to 0, and IR is 0 and IT also 0. Third property, perfectly black body is nothing but it is the athermonous body. Athermonous means that is no heat radiation pass through the perfectly black body. It is athermonous substance or athermonous body. And last property is perfectly black body, for perfectly black body, coefficient of absorption is equals to coefficient of emission. That is A is equals to E. What is coefficient of emission? We see later. So for perfectly black body, A is equals to E. It is also known as Kirchhoff's law. For perfectly black body, coefficient of absorption is equals to coefficient of emission. That is absorption coefficient is equals to emission coefficient. Means in short, we can say good absorber is a good emitter. That is, perfectly black body is good emitter, so because it is good absorber. That is, these are the properties of perfectly black body. But practically it is found that there is no perfectly black body found in the universe, because there are some examples of the perfectly black body. For example, platinum black and lamb black, these are the examples of perfectly black body. But actually it is found that lamb black and platinum black not absorb 100% heat radiation incident on it. They absorb about 98% heat radiation, so these are not a perfectly black body, ideally perfectly black body. These are the practical perfectly black body, that is platinum black and lamb black. But there is one experimental setup, that is a Frese perfectly black body. In this experimental setup, it is found that when the amount of energy incident inside this sphere, inside this Frese perfectly black body, then 100% heat radiations are absorbed. What is a Frese perfectly black body? This is experimental arrangement of the Frese perfectly black body. He take a double wall sphere. In figure, it is shown. That is double wall sphere having small aperture. There is a small aperture and this is double wall sphere. Inner side of the sphere is coated with the lamp black. There is a conical projection in opposite, diametrically opposite side of the aperture. This conical projection is used for the reflection in the different direction. This is Frese perfectly black body. In this, it is found that when some energy is incident through this aperture, through this hole, then lamp black absorb 98% heat radiation and 2% heat energy is reflected. Again, out of this 2%, 98% is absorbed and remaining energy is reflected, small amount of energy is reflected. In these 2 or 3 reflections or 2, 3, 5 reflections, 100% energy is absorbed by this Frese perfectly black body. This is just experimental setup of the Frese perfectly black body. This is about perfectly black body. Now we discuss about the two terms, that is emissive power. And what is about the emissive power of black body, emissive power of ordinary body, and what is emissivity. So first take what is emissive power. Emissive power is nothing but it is a amount of energy emitted per unit time per unit surface area is called as emissive power. Amount of energy emitted per unit time per unit surface area at a given temperature is called as emissive power of that body at that temperature. Because emissive power is different at different temperature. This is emissive power at a given temperature. So this is emissive power. Again, definition of emissive power, amount of energy emitted per unit time per unit surface area by the body at a given temperature is called as emissive power of that body at that temperature. This is emissive power of ordinary body. So that is emissive power, SI unit of emissive power is joule per second meter square, or we can say it's a watt per meter square. This is SI unit of emissive power. Again, one definition is emissive power of perfectly black body. Emissive power of perfectly black body means definition is same. That is the amount of energy emitted per unit time, per unit surface area by the perfectly black body at a given temperature is called as emissive power of perfectly black body at that temperature. That is emissive power of perfectly black body. Again, its SI unit is watt per meter square. That is emissive power. Emissive power of ordinary body is denoted by E, and emissive power of perfectly black body is denoted by EB. That is emissive power of ordinary body and emissive power of perfectly black body. Now we discuss about the coefficient of emission, or we can say it's a emissivity. Emissivity or coefficient of emission. It is defined as, shortly, emissivity is denoted by small e. So small e is equals to E by EB, means emissive power of ordinary body at a given temperature upon emissive power of perfectly black body at the same temperature is called as emissivity. So emissivity is nothing but it is the emissive power of ordinary body at a given temperature to the emissive power of perfectly black body at the same temperature is called as emissivity. So emissivity E is given by E by EB, capital E by capital EB, means emissive power of ordinary body upon emissive power of perfectly black body at the same temperature is called as emissivity. Okay. Now we discuss about the Prevost theory of heat exchange. Heat exchange means heat is given simultaneously, heat is taken. Exchange only. Exchange maita sarana. So that is a Prevost theory of heat exchange. In this theory, first point, everybody at every temperature except absolute zero temperature. Absolute zero temperature sodun baki kontyahi temperature la consider kela tari chalel. Everybody at every temperature emit as well as absorb radiations or heat radiations simultaneously at every temperature. Everybody at every temperature emit as well as absorb heat energy. Second point, amount of energy emitted by the body is totally depends on the temperature of the body, not depends on the temperature of surrounding. In this theory, there are three points. First point, when hot body kept in a cooler surrounding, means temperature of body is suppose capital T, is greater than the temperature of the surrounding. His body is hot than that of the surrounding. Means hot body when placed in a cooler surrounding, then it is found that amount of energy emitted by the body is greater than that of the amount of energy absorbed by the body. In short, we can say rate of emission is greater than rate of absorption. Means body emitted more amount of energy than it received, than it absorbed. So in this process, what happened? The body lost its energy. Body loses energy and temperature of body decreases. Means when hot body kept in a cooler surrounding, means T is greater than T0. T0 is the temperature of surrounding, T is the temperature of body. There is a loss of energy because more amount of energy is emitted and less amount of energy is absorbed. So there is a loss of energy and temperature of body decreases. Second point, when cold body placed in a hotter surrounding. So imagine kara ki cold body, suppose piece of ice is placed in a room temperature. That is cold body placed in a hotter surrounding, means T is less than T0. Again, T is the temperature of body, T0 is the temperature of surrounding. Then what happened? Body absorb more amount of energy than it emitted. Means rate of absorption is greater than the rate of emission. Absorption jasta asel, emission kami asel. And what happened? There is a gain of energy. Energy gain by the body, and so the temperature of body increases. But absorption and emissions are the continuous process. Third point, when the temperature of body is equal to temperature of surrounding. What is the temperature? And surrounding the temperature same ahe. That is the T is equals to T0. T is again temperature of body, T0 is the temperature of surrounding. Means T is equals to T0. Then what happen? Absorption and emissions are continuous process. There is exchange of heat. The rate of emission is equals to rate of absorption. Jevdi energy body emit karte ahe, tevdi energy body absorb suddha karte ahe. The rate of emission is equals to rate of absorption. So there is a no loss of energy, no gain of energy. So there is no increase or decrease of temperature. So temperature of body remains constant. But there is exchange of heat. This is Pihos theory of heat exchange.